mentioned the House of Representatives, and it's no more than a greatest honor that I have to introduce to you a congressman who has marched, who has gotten arrested, who has rallied, who has put the walk behind the talk. Senator Luis Gutierrez is our leader in the House. He's the chair of the Task Force on Immigration for both the Democratic Caucus and the House Congressional Hispanic Caucus, but he cares about immigration reform for all of America. I give you Representative Luis Gutierrez.
Gracias. The time is?
No.
The time is?
No.
And let me tell you who understands that better than anyone else in the Congress of the United States. We have Congressman Horsford right here with us. Congressman, give him a round of applause. Levanten la mano. Congresswoman Napolitano. Congressman Hinojosa. ¿Dónde está Serrano from New York? Congressman Serrano. From the fighting state of Arizona, Grijalva. Where's Congressman Luján? Ahí están. From Texas, Congressman Doggett is here with us. Congressman Becerra. Wait a minute. And there is somebody that's been working really hard from New York, Congressman. Charlie Rangel is here with us. And from Texas, San Antonio, el congresista Castro está con nosotros. And from those fighting Irish of New York, Congressman Joe Crowley. Anybody showed up from California? Because Tony Cardenas is here with us today. From New Jersey, Alvio Cires, dale un aplauso. Esa mujer que nunca descansa, que si se necesita un voto más para asegurarlo, Congresswoman Nidia Velázquez from New York. Someone who has been fighting for immigration reform and making sure that regardless of where you come from, whether it's the Dominican Republic or Jamaica, whether it's Ireland or Mozambique, no matter where you come from, she has stood up to defend the rights of immigrants here, Congresswoman Yvette Clark from New York. Mira, y dejé el último, no porque el menos importante. Pero mi amigo y nuestro nuevo colega, and our new colleague, from Florida, Joe Garcia. The time is?
No.
The time is?
No.
Like many of you, if we are citizens, we voted in November, and we watched on election night as the votes came in. And I don't care if you're watching on English TV or Spanish or in some other language. You saw how the very educated TV experts, one after another, said it was Latinos and Asians and African immigrants. It was their children and their friends and their families committed to their communities that returned Barack Obama to the White House. We delivered the votes that delivered the states like Nevada and Colorado and Nuevo Mexico and Florida to the Democrats, and these votes came with a great deal of hope and trust. The people who returned President Obama to the White House put trust in him and in the Democratic Party to deliver on what was promised. And it was not simply that they rejected the other candidate's approach. Yes, they rejected the call that every state passed laws like SB 1070 that was passed in Arizona. They rejected the threatened veto of a DREAM Act. Yes, we're all aware of that the other candidate and the other party had based their approach to immigration on driving 11 million undocumented immigrants out of the United States. by forcing them to self-deport. Latinos, Asian, African immigrant citizens and their families and allies voted in record numbers for President Obama, despite the most tremendous increase in deportations of any president in history. Despite 1,400 deportations a day and 1.6 million people forcibly removed from the United States. They knew that that was the road and that was the way to stop the deportations. And today we are here to say que se paren las deportaciones y permite la legalización. And we are here to make a simple and clear demand that the promises of immigration reform and going behind the dreamers, beyond the dreamers, now we have 500,000 young men and women, undocumented youth, that are safe from deportations, and now we say, bring your moms and your dads out of the shadows too. I will tell you what I've been telling people across the country. I will tell you what I've been telling people across the country. Work hard. Push us. Keep pushing us. And together we will deliver immigration reform this year. You need to guarantee that you give me and my colleagues and the Congress of the United States no place to hide. There are no acceptable excuses for failing to pass immigration reform this year, and no excuses will be accepted. For my own part, when I sense things are slowing down, I think of the woman who came to me in Salinas, California. She told me in a quiet voice that she could no longer wear a dress because she was so embarrassed to show her knees. Her knees that every day were knelt to cut garlic that flavors our food. Her knees that were so bruised and raw, she covers them with pants. She is one of the faces I have in my mind when I go to work on Make Immigration Reform a Reality. Her hands and her knees and her shoulders are a lot like other knees and hands and shoulders that put food on your table every day. But it's a funny thing about the hands and knees and shoulders that pick our fruit and vegetables. Those are the same arms that build our homes, care for our children, park our cars, clean our offices. Hands attached to people, knees and shoulders are attached to people. Y es hora que se respete la dignidad humana de esos trabajadores. So we must have laws that respect those people. Y ahora déjame decirle que yo estoy orgulloso de poder compartir esta tarima con mis colegas del Congreso de los Estados Unidos. Y sea Yvette Clark o Nidia Velázquez, como Raúl Grijalva o Joe García, nosotros estamos comprometidos con ustedes. Nosotros estamos comprometidos con sus hijos, con sus padres, con sus abuelos, con su familia, a parar las deportaciones de una vez y por todas aquí en este país. Deportaciones destructivas. Y quiero decirle a todos aquellos que levantaron su voz, paramos las deportaciones de nuestros jóvenes y ahora pararemos las deportaciones de sus mamás y sus papás y sus familiares. Gracias, gracias señor presidente por haber sido el que propuso la acción diferida. 500,000 de jóvenes ya no pueden ser deportados. Ahora queremos. Pero hemos venido aquí en este sol, aquí con el calor humano de ustedes. Medio millón es el pronto pago. Queremos 10 millones y más para que seamos todos iguales aquí en este país. Y para despedirme de ustedes, cuando yo me fui de mi casa anoche, when I left my house last night, and I said goodbye to my wife and to my children, they knew one thing, that I was coming back at the end of a work week here in Washington, D.C. We must understand the urgency of our fight and of our struggle. They will deport 1,400 people today. There will be 300 American citizen children who will come home to not find their dad or their mom. Hay urgencia en nuestra lucha. Las deportaciones que han sido tan destructivas. Pero ¿sabe lo que yo quiero? Yo quiero la misma garantía que tiene mi familia, que sabe que este viernes yo regresaré a ellos. Yo quiero esa misma garantía y que el gobierno garantice que todo el esposo que se va de sus hijos y toda la esposa que se va de sus hijos, cuando terminan su trabajo y su día de labor, pueden regresar a sus familias. Yo tengo esa protección. I have that protection. And we will fight until everyone who works in America and wants to return to their families has the same protection that every member of Congress has with you today. ¡Sí se puede! The time is...